Hey folks, I've got most of the stand done for the Sturtevant. There's still a lot of trim work to do. You know, I'm going to put corner trim on it and grills on it, kind of like this one's done. But for structural soundness, it's complete. Getting ready to start reassembly. I'm going to get the motor and the fan blade put in before I do the rest of the build on this. I took some Rust-Oleum hammer tone paint and sprayed it in the cap and then brushed it on to highlight the lettering. And there's some places where it looks like I got outside the lines, but really what's happened is the casting is not that good there. So I'll go back with some black and once it dries, mask it off and get that a little bit cleaner looking around there. But you know, it was never a polished, showpiece to begin with. It was industrial machinery. The nameplate I have clear coated and cleaned where it looks kind of nice. Used this 4x4 post with pretty heavy hardware. All I can tell you is if anything happens and this fan gets ripped out of the housing, I don't want to be anywhere near it, because that's a pretty serious timber framing in there to hold all that together. So all right, fixing to start putting the motor mounts in place and get the motor in. Got the motor set in there and the brackets put in place, and I haven't tightened any bolts yet because with so many pieces joining together on this structure, it's important to tighten them all gradually so nothing's in a bind in the end. And when I took this apart, it was in a bind. There was a lot of stress on it. So I'm going to be carefully tightening the bolts little by little till it's all firmed up and nothing's in a bind anymore. All the bolts are tightened down, motor's in place. Still turns good. Tiny little bit of in and out play like I wanted. So I believe it's going to be fan blade time now. Okay, she's all hooked up. I don't have oil in the oil jar on the motor there, but the bearings do have oil in them. I don't want to fill that jar up because then I have to deal with the oil leaking and spilling while I'm working on it. It's all hooked up to the VFD, and I'm fixing to go push the start button. So that's the motor current, the average current for all three phases. That is the amount of calculated power in kilowatts, so 0.6 kilowatts. And that is the power factor angle, which I'm not too familiar with that. I'm more used to it being a decimal number. So I'll have to see what that relates to in our normal power factor that we usually think about. That's the voltage and frequency. Okay, so it's running. I've got the RPM meter here. I'm going to put onto that shaft center. Remember, that motor's rated 425 RPM full load speed. Hard to get better than that. Nice sounding fan. Okay, I'm gonna go shut it down and we'll check the spin down time. The journal bearings with the 50 weight oil definitely work well, especially considering how heavy that fan blade is. Now, I ran it probably 20 minutes, and everything on this motor, all the bearing housings, the shaft, everything is absolutely stone cold. There's not any sign of warmth anywhere in it, even on the laminations there. So it definitely doesn't have anything wrong with it. Got a lot of details left on the running display build. Of course, I got to make a control panel, grills, the end corner moldings and everything to make it look good. The reason that this is all ghetto looking, I didn't put this cover on, my test cord doesn't have any kind of ferrule terminals on it, and I figured that up in here that might somehow touch inside that and short out, so I ran it with that off for now. Another thing I didn't show in the other video, I put a new grommet right there to protect the new stator lead wires. I don't know, I may have to take a break from working on fans for a while and go do some other things, but when I get back, more work on this one. And also, I think I glossed over some stuff on putting the fan back together. It was kind of intentional, because as you know, there's two of these, so anything that there's interest in, I can go into more detail on the second one of the two and make a little longer video. Well, anyway, I appreciate your interest in this really old, really amazing fan, and I'm so glad to see it run, and it has a great sound. It's very soothing sound. I can see why that would be good for a theater. If it was mounted up in the ceiling at a distance, you'd barely hear that. All right, catch you later.